Welcome to the bazaar for selective abortion. Here in Bhubaneswar, the state capital of Orissa, finding out the sex of your unborn child is as easy as going to a local store. But this flourishing cottage industry has been rocked by the grisly discovery of over 130 fetuses dumped in various parts of the state. At the center of this feticide scandal is Nayaghar, a small town 100 kilometers from Bhubaneswar. The chance discovery 3 weeks ago of 7 fetuses abandoned on a hill outside the town caught the local administration by surprise. They decided to shut, as a result, all the privately run clinics offering ultrasound scans to determine the sex of an unborn child and the nursing homes where abortions are carried out. This included Krishna Clinic, which in turn led them to the next gruesome discovery. This plot of land is owned by Sabita Sahu, the same person who runs Krishna Clinic. From this deep well dug on her plot, the police recovered at least 70 decomposed fetuses, which had been packed into polythene bags, stuffed with boric acid, and then thrown into the well over a period of time. The well has been sealed by the police, but clearly what happened in Nayaghar is merely the tip of the iceberg. In the southern city of Bangalore, 20 fetuses were found dumped in plastic bags on Monday. And last month, a doctor in the national capital, New Delhi, was arrested after aborted babies were found in a septic tank at his practice.
Actually, Nayagarh jo chota shahar hai aur wo thoda isolated hai uske upar ye itna vikasit bhi nahi hai to ye log samajhte honge ki wahan par hoga to kisi ka nazar nahi padega to isliye wo ek center ban gaya lekin aisa nahi ki sirf Nayagarh hi ek center hai abhi Bhubaneswar mein 5 din pehle nikala gaya hai usko malam ko mila hai to ye Bhubaneswar Katak Baleshwar har bade jo jila hai jo jila headquarter isi mein ye ho raha hai.
The discoveries of dumped fetuses have spurred a public outcry in Orissa, which has forced clinic owners to dispose of any incriminating evidence. Behind Bhubaneswar Diagnostic Centre, Ganesh Das shows me where he spotted a clinic employee with a carton of 15 jars.
तो हमको जब उसको हम क्या चीज़ छुपा रहा है उसको देखने से इतना बड़ा बड़ा जार में वो लड़की मतलब लड़की का जैसा छोटा बच्चा जैसा होता है उसका खोपड़ी छोटा छोटा निकल रहा है अभी हाँ उसको निकल रहा है लेकिन मांस का इतना बड़ा बड़ा मांस का जितना है वो सब पड़ा था जब हम फ़ोन किया थाने को कैपिटल PS मिस्टर हरिहर दोरा जो IIC है उनको फ़ोन किया सर ऐसा ऐसा प्रॉब्लम है इधर और क्या करें ना जाने दीजिए आपका भी होगा लड़की आप भी ऐसा करेंगे वो चलता है चलता रहेगा उसको कोई नहीं रोक पाएगा हाँ ऐसा बोल के वो अवॉइड कर लिया हमको
द पुलिस वुड रादर हैव दिस स्कैंडल गो अवे दे प्राइवेटली एडमिट फीटिसाइड इज अ कॉमन प्रैक्टिस बट टिल दीज फीटसेस वर डिस्कवर्ड Most were not even aware of the provisions of the Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act of 1994. According to this, it is illegal to reveal the gender of a fetus. But the ultrasound machine itself is legal and is used in diagnosing any complications during pregnancy. The proliferation of these machines is what is causing this jump in feticides. Cheap Chinese machines are now available for just £2,500, half the price of American ones. Every small town doctor can now get one, and more families can afford the £4 it costs for the test. A worrying development is that government doctors are often hand in glove with the private clinics they are supposed to regulate. Under the law, the chief medical officer or CMO is responsible for preventing selective abortions at the district level. Yet in Nayaghar, for instance, the deputy CMO worked regularly at Krishna Clinic in his free time. He has been arrested and is now in judicial custody.
The setup provided under the act has to be looked into. Whether when the government doctors are involved, whether it is all right to leave the entire regulation in the hands of CDMO or the health department, or maybe perhaps we have to go for some regulatory, independent regulatory commission or that sort of thing. It has to be looked into.
The state administration has responded to the scandal by launching a series of raids on private clinics and nursing homes. I accompanied a government team that included a health official, local magistrate and a policeman. They verified the clinic's license and looked into a few rooms. But it was a perfunctory inspection and the clinic obviously had had enough time to clean up.
Ultrasound clinic should be registered properly. If it is not registered properly, then it will be sealed.
The crackdown on private medical establishments has shaken doctors. They feel they are being targeted because they are soft targets. Many have simply disappeared to escape the ongoing scrutiny. And this could put enormous pressure on the state's healthcare system, with over 70% being provided by private-run medical institutions. These have now decided not to carry out any abortions till the crackdown ends.
The Association of the Private Nursing Homes has met yesterday night and they have decided an agenda not to carry out this MTP and all in all private nursing homes. They have come out with a resolution. Ultimately, who suffers by this? It is the patient.
The mix of old customs and new technology means a widening gender deficit that could haunt India for decades. The latest figures from a sample registration system, which covers over 1 million households, shows that for the 2 years up to 2005, India had just 880 female babies born for each 1,000 males. As a result, violence against women is increasing. It has already gone up by 23% in the last year alone. Karan Singh, Channel 4 News, Nayaghar.